Today, we are going to be going back in time and taking a look at the best FIFA My Player ever made. And yes, as you can see, we are on the FIFA 2014 World Cup game mode for Brazil. And trust me when I say this, you're about to find out today why this is honestly not even the best My Player ever made, probably the best FIFA game ever made in general. We're going to be checking out the Captain Your Country mode, which is the World Cup version of the My Player. And I just love this right here. Countdown to the World Cup, 3,124 days. I'm guessing it's actually reverse and it's counting. It is a countdown. So what is this one counting down to? Or is it going, I don't know, because what is in this many days? Obviously we're past the World Cup. Does anyone know what's gonna happen when this reaches zero? How many years is 3,124 days?
It's 8.55 years.
Hey, I literally just asked Siri how many years that is. Once that hits zero, it will be in 8 years and I think 6 months. So maybe in the next 8 years, we'll revisit this and I'll do the episode, what happens when this countdown reaches zero. Right into it we go. Captain Your Country. Here we go. It starts with the sports talk radio and I would let you listen to this, but it's just kind of gets annoying. But pretty much what this goes on and talks about is the team that you're taking control of, the World Cup, the players on your squad, what you have to compete against. It literally is like a talk show giving you a rundown of your squad. And then we start with choosing your nation. And the best part about this is you don't just have to choose one of the 32 teams that qualified for the World Cup. You start your journey before qualification. So you can literally pick any nation you want and help lead them to the World Cup final. And when I say any nation, you can literally use North Korea. I mean almost any freaking nation in the world. I'm honestly tempted, but no, we're gonna actually choose a legitimate nation. But just going through some of them, like literally US Virgin Islands, some of the smallest nations in the world. The Virgin Islands are ranked 190th in the world. You can see every team's world rankings, their wins, qualifications. We could choose Aruba. I think for the sake of the episode, though, I actually want to go for a bigger nation. And we'll definitely choose a European nation for this. But it just starts here with how great this is. You can literally randomize. We got Lithuania. Randomize again. We get Ireland, Lithuania again, Georgia. I think for the sake of it, I'm rocking the England kit. Let's do it. Let's find England. Where are we at? England, 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 England. There we go. Okay, let's do it. Let's go for England. And before you even start, how awesome is this? You can do multiplayer My Player. If you have four friends with you, you could click four. You each get to create your own player for your country. And you play every game with four players, each controlling your own creative player all the way from qualification to the World Cup final. I can't even imagine, man. I'm sure so many people had so much fun with this, just getting all their freaking mates together, each creating their player, leading their home country to a World Cup final. I have no friends here right now.
Hello, darkness, my old friend.
So it's just gonna be me. We're choosing one and we can use an existing player. We could choose an England beast, but I'm just gonna create my own. So let's go with this. It gave me the name Oscar White. We'll stick with it. We'll choose a random kit number because I don't think we deserve the number 9 just yet. But the customization is literally the same actually. Besides some of the appearance features, everything else is the complete same as it currently is in FIFA. We'll just create a center forward, finisher. We're not going to be playing through all this. I'm literally just kind of walking you through the process. Next, we get to set up our fixtures. Do we want to choose real fixtures, the actual groups for the qualifications, or do we want to create our own? Let's just go with what was set up in real life. So here they are. Here are all of the qualifying groups for the FIFA World Cup. We're in Group H, Ukraine, Poland. Obviously, England qualified for this World Cup, but we gotta go through the qualification process again. And we get this cool little newspaper here. Rod Hodgson's England squad gets a boost today as Oscar White returns from a lengthy spell out on injury. So that's the storyline. We're coming back from injury, and this is so dope. If you keep reading, it says he will be featured in upcoming B-team games. So, you don't start at the World Cup, no. You don't start at qualifiers, no. You start before the qualifiers. You have to earn your spot into the qualification team, earn your spot into the World Cup team. Nothing is given to you in this. And this is your starting screen. This is the menu that you will go through the entire World Cup in. So let's show you a few of the features. First, we'll take a look at our rivals. So we are currently ranked 46th in the England squad. We are the worst player in England right now. We have to earn our spot in the team, like I said. And here are our first four rivals that we have to go up against. Obviously, if you were playing with your friends, if you added four players, all of these four players would be the people who you are with. So we are still not even on the B international team. We are literally just trying out for the team. This is a straight trial for us. We have Lewis Thomas in 45th, Ryan Bertrand at 43, and Jake Livermore at 41. And you can see we are completely at the bottom. So we have 6 games until the first cut, as it says. If we don't succeed, it could literally end before we even make it to the qualification rounds. We are literally given a tryout right now to the team, and it goes up the list. B International, on the radar, fringe players, and then the international squad. You can see some familiar faces here. Alex Oxlade-Chamberlain is a fringe player. You have Sterling on the radar. Oh my God, that's so funny. Welbeck in the international. And then after international, if you make the top 23, we all know what happens. You get called up to the World Cup squad. So here's the England World Cup squad. And number one on the list, it has to be the captain, Steven Gerrard. Now, this is the cool thing. I think it's possible. Obviously, I have not played through an entire World Cup yet, but you can make it all the way up to number one, I believe. You can literally take Gerrard's captain's arm sleeve. I think, I want to say you can. Again, I haven't gone through this yet. Let's maybe show you a bit of gameplay here as well. We'll start with the team sheet right here. Just the way they present things. The menus are so much cleaner than FIFA 20. The way they show the team sheet, like it's written on a piece of paper, is awesome. It's just the little things. You have all the sponsors down there below. Everything you need right here. We'll click advance, we'll move on, and you get to control the players you want. So obviously, if you were playing with four players, you switch the controller over the players you want to control. So we'll control our player, Oscar White, and we will get into this with England. And here is the World Cup presentation. I freaking love it, man. I miss the World Cup so much. I miss international football in general. Obviously, the Euros are canceled now, but here it is. The first B team international game. Yo, there's actually a pretty good sized crowd for it being a B team international. Wembley Stadium, our starting 11. Another thing about this that you can't do is get subbed on, but you've never been able to do that. And I think the history of FIFA. I'm not gonna show you too much of the gameplay because it's just normal FIFA 20, or FIFA 20, what am I saying? It's just normal FIFA 14 gameplay. It's the only downside. The menus are awesome. The display is awesome. The way you rank up throughout the squad is crazy, but it's just FIFA 14 gameplay. Even though the new FIFA's gameplay aren't that great either, I'd still probably take it over this, but it does bring back the memories. It's just so much quicker. It's so arcadey, if that makes sense. It doesn't feel like an actual FIFA. And oh my God, what a through ball. Are we actually gonna score? Let's freaking go. White, are you joking me? Oh my God. All right, I gotta get one goal. Let's go for it. Finesse shot, my own teammate. Jonjo Shelvey blocks it. What are you doing? This is ridiculous. Pass back. Finesse shot. Let's go, boys. There it is. All right, our boy White slots it home. Like I said, this is the only gameplay I'm about to show you guys. And after each game, the way you rank up is based off of your performance. So we scored a goal there. I simulated till the end of the game. And let's see what stats get boosted. If our overall gets boosted, we go up to a 67 overall, and then we move up to rank 45 on the team sheet. So wait, who did we surpass here? I'm gonna have to check that out. Right, we've overtaken the man Jack Butland, who's gone down to 46. So if I really wanted to, I could take my time here and work my way all the way up. Next thing we got to showcase is the training, and this is something that I wish was implemented in FIFA. First off, they have freaking Adidas sponsoring the training, which is so cool. You get to pick which drill you want, and the training directly impacts how you progress throughout the team. You can upgrade your player. You can overtake players via the ranking, which is something that would be so cool to set up in FIFA 20, FIFA 21 for the future. Pretty much what I'm saying, I'm just gonna kind of do this training drill by myself. You can see how my rivals have done. We're gonna set it up now. But what I've been saying is that this would be so cool to implement into a future FIFA. We should be able to start on a B team. We should have to work our way up to get into the team. It shouldn't be we can just join Barcelona and start instantly. It's one of my least favorite things about the My Player. It's so unrealistic. I don't know why the FIFA 14 World Cup My Player is the best FIFA My Player ever made. I know why, because of the features, but why couldn't they have used what they used in this game mode as I'm just failing this training, Joe? Why couldn't they have used that in future FIFAs? Why did it have to end here? I have a thought that it probably has a lot to do with Ultimate Team. But it's just so unfair to all the people who love this game mode, who love career mode in general. We deserve more than this, man. And like, no, we deserve this right here. We don't deserve the My Player we've gotten in FIFA for, I don't even freaking know, the past however many years. I really suck at this training drill, don't I? Oh my God. But yeah, as you can see, here are our results. So we tied Thomas there. So I don't think we're going to be advancing past anyone after that training drill. Let's take a look. Are we? Are we still at 45? Yeah, so we stay right at 45 and get plus one for the passing. Okay, I'm going to take a minute of my time here. Obviously, this is going to be real quick for you. I want to see if I can advance, how far I can advance in this team right now. I'm going to go into a bunch of games on just like beginner difficulty and score as many goals as I can to try to get into the international or top 23. Let's see if I can do it.
1 eternity later.
Okay, right. I have literally just been sitting here playing beginner for about an hour, just trying to work my way up this team, and we've made progress. We were just in the tryout stage before you just saw the last scene, and we've worked our way all the way up into 20 seconds, and we are now in the World Cup squad, and we haven't even gotten to qualification games yet. So I think I've proven that, yeah, you can actually become the number one rated player in this game as my controller. It's dying here, stupid Xbox 360 controller. But no, this is the best game mode. You can see we now have new rivals as we have sort of progressed. Our new rivals are Ashley Young, Danny Welbeck, Adam Lallana, and our boy Oscar White. We could keep going. We could pass Gerrard. And, well, we're definitely not now. The game literally just crashed on me. This is why we can't have nice things. And now we have a black screen. Okay, this might be the end of the episode. Right, boys, I appreciate you guys watching if you made it to the end of the video. Do you want to see more retro My Player videos? I would low-key consider doing a series on this game mode and starting from the bottom, working our way up all the way to the top, doing it legitimately, like now. That's how good I think this game is. Obviously, the gameplay isn't ideal. It's just, I don't know. It's just old and people like new stuff. This is old, but the features are awesome. I think you guys can agree with me. I don't know. Regardless, do you guys want to see more retro My Player videos? Let me know. We will have a new FIFA 20 My Player video coming tomorrow. Thank you guys so much for watching. We'll catch you boys later. Peace.